Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today in this C Sharp tutorial we are going to learn about ListBox and C Sharp. So let's start. So I created this form and which is empty. So I'll drag in a ListBox on this form. So I'll search here for ListBox and here it is. I will drag in and now I will extend it a bit. I will go expand it to the top also and to the bottom as well. Now I'll remove this text from it. I'll change the name to country or foot. Countries will be best. Countries list box. And now I'll go here down to items and now I'll click on this collection and here I will add some items. So the first will be UK and then USA and then Australia, then India, then Pakistan, then Iran, then Afghanistan, and then China, and then Saudi, UAE, and Qatar, and then Syria, and then Yemen, and let me make this capital, this Y, and now if I click OK, all these items will be added into this list box. Now we will check some properties of this list box. First we will check this selection mode property. So if I run this, now if I select an item, only one item will be selected. If I select it with shift key, only one item is selected, and if I select it with control key, only one item is selected. Now we will enable multiple selection. So I'll go to design, click on this, and now I will come to the selection mode. Here it is, and I will change it to from one to multi sample. And now if I run this, and now if I select a single one, and I can select multiple as well. Now if I use shift, I can select single object and deselect them singly. Now if I close this, and now if I again go to selection mode and make this multiple extended, and now if I run this application, and now if I select this first one and then I press the shift key and click the last one, so all will be selected in a single click. So this is a multiple extended, multi extended. Now we have also another one called none, and now if I run this, and now if I select an element, it will not be selected because we made the selection none. Now I'll again come to properties, and now I will use check for the column property. So the property is a multi-column, this one. Now it is false. Now if I enable this and make this true, and now if I go to this collection and now I copy this, control C this, and now I paste it at the end and then paste it again and then paste it again. Now if I click OK, now you can see that multiple columns are created in this list box. So if I run this, now I can scroll through these columns. You can see three columns are created in this scroll bar. So I'll close this and now I'll go to collection, edit this, and I will backspace all, and now I will control V once, and now click OK, and I'll go to this multi column and I will make this false. Now we will add a button here, and with this button click, we will add an item into this list box. So I'll go to this toolbox button. Now I'll extend this button and I'll make this a bit larger so that it looks good, and I'll extend it again, and now I'll make this add, and now here the button name will be add button. Now I'll add in I'll duplicate this by clicking by pressing control and dragging it down, and then I will drag it again, so this one will be remove single item, and then this will be used for count, and this one will use for clearing all the lists at once. Now so this one will become remove single btn, and now this so I will change the text on this as well. So I'll change this to remove single item, and I will change this to count items, count btn, and now I'll use here count items. Now and this will be clear list, now I'll come at the top and here I will use clear list btn, and now I will add the functionality. So I will double click on this to add the click event, and here I will use countries on dot items dot add, and sorry I forgot to add the text box for the country. So I'll come to this design, and now here I will quickly make a place for a text box, and now I will go to toolbox, and from here I will drag in a text box, and now I'll place it here, and I'll extend it. Now I will enter a name here, so this is text box, so I will change this its name, and I will make this country country text box, and now I'll double click on this button to go to its click event, and here I will use country text box dot text. Now if I run this application, and now if I enter a country here, Iraq, IRAQ, and now if I add, so it added Iraq. Now if I add another one, if I enter Japan, now it has added Japan. Now we will remove a single item from this list. So I'll close this, and now I'll go to design, and now I'll double click on this. Now now we will use country list box dot items dot remove, and now I will use country list box dot selected item, and now I'll put semicolon here, and now if I run this, and now if I select an item, we cannot select an item because we have made this selection none. So I'll go to design, select this, and now I will search for selection mode. So this is, so I'll make this one, and now if I run this, and now if I select this Afghanistan, and if I click on this remove, you can see Afghanistan is removed, and now if I click on this, it will be removed. Now the next is we will show the count of items here in a message box. So I'll use message box dot show, and now here I will use, so I'll use list box country list box dot items dot count, and now I'll put semicolon, but this count is int, so I will may change it to string, and now I will run this application, and now if I click on this count, it will show us the count of the countries list box, and now if I add another Japan, add, and now if I count this, now it is 14, and now if I add another country, Iraq, and then add, it will be 15 now. 15 now. Okay, now I'll clear the whole list. Now for that I will click here, I go to design, and now I'll double click on this clear list, and I will use list box country list box dot items dot clear, and now I'll put a semicolon here, and now if I run this, and now if I click this clear list, now the whole list box is cleared. So that's all for today. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please like, subscribe and comment.